There was a time when the drive from Bombay to Lonavala would take about 3 hours. Up and down the curving ghats with cars that halted every few minutes. But today, better connectivity, infrastructure and technology has ensured that you can take a trip to Lonavala by the time I'm done with this speech. And while that may be an exaggeration, there is no denying that there is an influx of development and construction that has surged through our country in this past decade, from high rises to national highways to the metro lines. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. The idea of today's speech is to explore the landscape of infrastructure development versus environmental safety, the legal confrontation. The word development is synonymously used with the word progress. And ever since land has been reclaimed from the sea in our very own city, our country has not looked back in making the lives of its citizens more convenient. Is it any wonder then that the Indian government has promised to invest $1.5 trillion into infrastructure? But this comes at a price. Not at a monetary price, but something far more valuable. As it is rightly said, an investment isn't an investment if it destroys a planet. But this price is not essential to be paid. Infrastructure is necessary, but it must coexist with environmental safety and vice versa. If there is development in, say, the transport system and connectivity, then there would be a drastic reduction in the usage of irreplaceable fossil fuels as well as idling emissions. For every 10 minutes you leave your car engine off, you prevent 1 pound of carbon dioxide from being released. The Supreme Court of India has ruled that BS4 vehicles will no longer be produced after March 2020 and they will introduce BS6 vehicles with stricter and a more restrictive norm to combat air pollution. Furthermore, GST on electric vehicles are set to be slashed from 12% to 5%. India has what is claimed to be a green budget, as it has allotted $420 million into the environment this year. But the allocation of such a budget is still a mystery. And even if we did know about the allocation, is such an expense enough to undo the years of damage done? The crux of the matter lies in maintaining a status quo between infrastructure development and environmental safety. And that status quo can be answered in two simple words. Sustainable development, that is meeting the needs of the present without compromising the needs of the future generations. The Air Act, Water Act, Environmental Protection Act, and Wildlife Protection Act are the statutes in force protecting the environment in our country. But they are nothing more than toothless tigers at the risk of being oppressed by political and vested interests. A right to clean environment is a fundamental right under Article 21, and we must fight to uphold it against polluting industrialists who think that they can get away with just a slap on the wrist and simple payment of damages. Let's focus on the current scenario. The Amendment Act prevents the court from granting specific relief in the form of injunctions to those suits in wherein the contract relates to infrastructure projects. This is worrying as the intent is to reduce court intervention in infrastructure projects. It showcases that the current government prizes its prime concern on infrastructure development rather than looking at environmental safety and leaves ample room to overlook the same. This even involves curbing the power of our very own courts. Whether it is the destruction of the green lungs, such as the RA, due to political pressure in the name of infrastructure development, or the destruction of the mangroves, advocates must be willing to take up such matters for the bona fide benefit. After all, isn't that what law is about? Striving for public welfare? But there is hope. The High Court has quashed all clearances under the CRZ notifications for the Mumbai Coastal Road project. The civic body has been asked to get fresh environmental clearances under environmental impact assessment. That very reclaimed land that we stand on today will soon be underwater with other low-lying areas. So answer me this. What is the point in building such a marvelous city only to be swept away by the neglect of our environment? Just as Mr. Ratan Tata tweeted this week, the idea is not to test the limit of a planet and find out how much more damage it can take. but to come together and restore and reverse. We owe it to every generation that is to come. Thank you.